Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron here, New Life Pentecostal Church, Albany, Georgia. I hope you're having an awesome day in Jesus. This is a fascinating book, especially if you like the King James, but maybe even if you don't like the King James, because it just shows the impact of the King James Version of the Bible on the English language, or at least a small extent of it. There's many learned tomes on that particular subject about the authorized version and the English language. A lot of people talk about the KJV becoming archaic, not realizing that the KJV is kind of what holds the English language together, that and the works of Shakespeare. That is the basis for the English language. So what this is, you know, fascinating collection of popular expressions from the Bible. He's got a bachelor's degree from Baylor, master's degree from Houston. It's Stephen Melvin McCallop. And I'm just going to open this, and you're going to see that there's into the hundreds of recognizable phrases that seem to have their beginnings with the King James Version of the Bible. And it's just fascinating once you see the impact of the King James Version of the Bible in everyday language. Like, I'll read an article from the New York Times or the Wall Street Journal or the New Yorker or Vanity Fair or something, and I'm just like, they're quoting the Bible. They can't get away from the Bible, such as Psalm 42:6, "Oh my God, hallelujah," and "Oh, spare me." Psalm 39:13, old wives' tales, old days, once and for all, Hebrews 10:10, one and the same, 1 Corinthians 12:11, one way or another, Ezekiel 21:16, out of sight, out of mind, Psalm 31:12, out of the body experience, 2 Corinthians 12:2, out of the mouth of babes, Psalm 8:2, parting of the ways, you know, past the time. And it just goes through. And then at the end, the wages of sin. It's got a great little bibliography here, too, that somebody who's interested in this. Maybe you're just interested in the English language. You're not really interested in the King James Version of the Bible. I remember I sold a Bible to a English teacher one time, and they brought it back like 3 days later and said, "This thing does not follow the rules of English." I'm like, it predates the rules of English. You know, 1611, they didn't come up with these things till just modern times. And all of this. So the once popular biblical expressions used less frequently today: abomination of desolation, ancient of days, answer a fool according to his foolishness, answer a fool according to his folly, as one man, balm in Gilead, be of good cheer, bear false witness, beard the lion, before the flood, bound hand and foot, broken. So, I mean, I still see a lot of these: cast out devils, cast into outer darkness, chew the cud, child of the devil, children of the world, citizen of no mean city, cloud no bigger than a man's hand. So these are things, I mean, you just say these, and if somebody's been in America for any length of time, it just, it unifies you. You're just all of a sudden, yeah, that echoes in my DNA, maybe. And such as memes, they say some things can actually possibly be engraved in your DNA, but that's for another time in a Science in the Bible video. So just say the word. Great little book, and I hope you'll just read your King James Version of the Bible if you're an English speaker. If you're not, read something that's equivalent in your language, or learn English. But God bless you. Love you in Jesus' name.